Okay, so welcome back. So in the last class I started introducing this concept of potential temperature or theta, which is a very important concept in atmospheric thermodynamics. Okay, so let's revisit the definition. Okay, the potential temperature theta of an air parcel is defined as the temperature that the parcel of air would have if it were expanded or compressed adiabatically from its existing pressure and temperature to a standard pressure, okay, which is P naught, generally taken to be 1000 h bar. So it is at a pressure of P and temperature of T. It is taken to a pressure of P naught. It will reach a temperature there if this is adiabatic. Okay, if it's adiabatic, this could be adiabatic compression or expansion. This theta is called the potential temperature. Okay, so the challenge is to be able to calculate the potential temperature for any set of P and T, correct? So it is like a reference point. So we should be able to calculate the reference point, and so with this we can do, this will aid us or help us in solving problems involving adiabatic transformations. All right. So first, let us figure out what is the relationship between P T and P naught theta. All right. So P naught is dQ from the first law. I am going to expand d of pv as pdv plus vdp. One of these things will get cancelled. I will write dh as cp into dt. So you need not wait for me, you can go ahead. And it is adiabatic, so you can set the left hand side to 0. And you can start, you can integrate. So the limits are p to p naught and t to theta. So you can straight away get an expression for theta in terms of the two pressures and the temperature. All right, I'll just give you 2 minutes. So please do it, then I will do it on the board. So please expand from this. You can substitute the value for Cp, you can substitute the value for R, take R equal to Rd, you will get some constant to the power of some 0.286, correct? Are you getting that? Okay, so adiabatic, correct? But what is rho? P by RT, correct? Now please integrate, substitute the limits. Is it okay up to this stage? I'll just give you 2 more minutes. Integrate. Done? Is okay? To the power of? R, let us put some equation numbers. R is approximately RD. What is this fellow? Value of this fellow? Very good. 2 87. Therefore, or 1005, whatever. Fine. 2.85. You are getting. I think 0.286. Doesn't matter. 2.85. 2.86. All right. Therefore, an important equation we derived in today's class. Okay. For any given set of conditions P and T, for any state of the atmosphere, you can find the corresponding potential temperature. Okay. So, This is the equation for potential temperature from 15. Okay. Why is this concept very useful? Can you tell me some reason? Why is this concept very useful? Let us start with the first thing is, many processes in the atmosphere are adiabatic. Okay? We will just prove in a little while the theta is conserved during an adiabatic process. So, when adiabatic transformations take place, the theta is a constant with which you can simplify some calculations. So, theta is a very useful construct. Okay. So, theta is like rho for an incompressible fluid, which does not change. Whenever the velocity is increasing, area is decreasing, increasing, pressure is increasing, water means 1000 kilogram per meter cube. Air is a problem, that's a, air is compressible, but water is incompressible. So, it's like rho for an incompressible fluid. Suppose you say, sir, how are you, how do you know that theta is conserved during adiabatic process? First, you know, believe me, we'll prove it in a few minutes. Okay, so theta is like rho for an, what did I say, for an incompressible. The potential temperature is an important concept. Okay, you can construct charts with potential temperature as one of the coordinates. They will be called adiabatic charts, pseudo-adiabatic charts and all that. So, with this contraption, we will use it tomorrow, it will come up and I will start drawing the various lines. I will take the chart, we are setting it up. So, constant temperature, constant pressure, constant theta, all these lines we will draw and then we will start solving atmospheric science problems with some charts. Okay, I will distribute the charts to you, so you can do it there. I will do it on the board and then at the end of the class we can save it and I can actually take a printout also every problem we solve. So, we will switch to tablet in due course. All right. So far so good. Problem number 20. Problem 20, very good. This is lecture number 15, I think. Okay, doesn't matter. Please decide. Problem number 20. Problem 20. Prove that for an adiabatic process. Prove that for an adiabatic process undergone by an ideal gas, prove that for a reversible adiabatic process undergone by an ideal gas, PV to the power of gamma is a constant. Isentropic is, we do not have to introduce entropy in this course. Later on I will introduce. Reversible and adiabatic is also called isentropic. Entropy remains constant. Okay. So, I lost the flow. What did you say? Prove that for a reversible and adiabatic process, for an ideal gas, reversible and adiabatic process of an air parcel, of an air parcel which can be considered to be an ideal gas, PV to the power of gamma is equal to constant. All that you do not have to question, simply can write PV to the power of, prove PV to the power of gamma is constant. Then using PV to the power of gamma is constant and the concept of potential temperature, we will say that potential temperature is preserved or conserved during adiabatic process. So, we are actually confirming the statement which we made a couple of minutes ago. Okay. Please do it. Problem 20. So, I will erase this. So already it is adiabatic, right? So where do you start? Yeah, first law. You start with the first law. Okay. So what is that? Yes, please tell me. CV, where did you start? No. CP dt, let us hang on. dp by v, rho. You want to do this or no?
No.
You are keeping this. Now. You are substituting for P here?
I did by 1.
You can write another equation.
Yeah, you can substitute for P here, isn't it?
You can substitute for T here.
I substitute for T. So T is equal to P V by R.
You are already having DT, na?
So basically I converted DT into DV. Yeah.
Fine. How do you do that?
So T is equal to P V by R.
P V by R.
And DV will be V DP by R plus P DV by R.
You are complicating things.
So in the first law itself we can take dw equal to minus du.
There are many ways of doing it. Tell it a simpler way. Can you substitute for v here? Will it come? P by? PV equal to RT. RT by? RT by P. So CP, what is this? That's what we got, right? Okay, so T2 by T1 is I lost track of the equation numbers. You can start if you want 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, I am reading it too fast. Just focus on this for 2 minutes. Let this be. I think it is too fast. Just please assimilate the steps. You all finish, right? So. Shall we continue? Okay. Okay, this is an important result. In mechanical engineering, you are talking about the Brayton cycle. The Brayton cycle is used to power gas turbines. Okay, is the thermodynamic cycle used for powering gas turbines, which are used for the aircrafts. So, if you take the gas from the pressure P1 and temperature T1 and compress it to P2 and T2, at the end of the compression stroke, when the compression ratio is P2 by P1, what will be the temperature at the end of the compression is obtained by this. After it reaches a temperature of T2, combustion takes place, it will reach a temperature of T3, which will be much higher compared to T2. Then it will expand, it will go to T4, then from T4, if it is an open cycle gas turbine, it will just come out. If it is a closed cycle gas turbine, it will be recycled, it will come back to T1 and the cycle is completed. Okay. So, that is the gas turbine cycle. An air standard cycle is one in which the properties can be assumed with that of air, which is not strictly correct because at somewhere the combustion products are getting mixed up. But since the air fuel ratio is so high, we can assume that everything is consisting of just air. Dry air, then you can do the calculation. That is called a air standard cycle analysis. Okay, this is a 2-minute course on gas turbine cycles. You can have advanced gas turbine cycle and with intercooler and this thing and all that. Okay, let's get back to this. Now, please combine the two and you will get the result. Mr. Sajid, is it okay? There are many ways of doing it, but you cannot deny that this is a method, this is a way of doing it. Okay? And during the process, I also taught you about gas turbine. Okay? So, let us combine these two. The problem is stem from the fact that you are taught shortcuts in GE. Profs never use shortcuts. We will explain step by step. What is the hurry? There is no time limit for the exam, right? This is not an exam. Clarity is very important. Correct? Usually I do not miss steps in derivations. All right. Now combining these two. Shall I straight away write? Okay. Proved. Okay. This is good. Problem number 21. Prove that the potential temperature of an air parcel does not change. Prove that the potential temperature of an air parcel does not change when the parcel moves around under adiabatic and reversible conditions. Under adiabatic and reversible conditions in the atmosphere, under adiabatic and reversible conditions in the atmosphere. Let me come again. Problem number 21, prove that the potential temperature, if you want, prove that the potential temperature theta of an air parcel does not change when the parcel moves around under reversible and adiabatic conditions in the atmosphere. Please solve. I will just wait for 2 minutes, then I will start solving. Yes, are you able to prove it? Without using p to the power of gum also I can prove. There are many ways of proving this. Let me teach you a way of what did I do? Okay. So I just use the concept of potential temperature itself. Okay. So this is an interesting way of doing. If you use the P1V1 to the power of gum also, you can get it. Shall I erase the whole thing? Is it 20? To prove. So the fellow is going from this adiabatic process taking place in the atmosphere. He is going, he means the parcel, he is going from P1 V1 to P2 V2. But the link is that PV to the power of gamma is constant. But what I am saying is for the there is one T1, correct? There is also a T2, which can be got straight away from the ideal gas equation. PV equal to RT. Now, for this P1 and T1, there is a theta 1. This is the potential temperature. Theta 1 is equal to T1 to the power of gamma by gamma minus 1. For this fellow, R by CP, no, it should be fine, no? P0 by P1, gamma by gamma minus, gamma minus 1 by gamma, yeah, correct, now it's correct, right? Fine, good. Now P2, T2, now theta 2, I feign that theta 1 equal to different from theta 2, I don't know as yet. Okay, so I get a new theta 2, which is T2 of P0 by okay. Now therefore theta 2 by theta 1 is nothing but T2 by T1 to the power of, then what I am getting is P1 by P2. Agreed. But T2 by T1 is P2 by P1 to the power of gamma minus 1 by gamma, already proved. Yeah, just I'll give you 2 minutes to assimilate this. So theta 2 by theta 1 equal to 1. If theta 2 is the same as theta 1. Therefore, the potential temperature theta is conserved during an adiabatic transformation. Yes, class, please tell me what are the other ways of proving. If somebody is putting his hand up, we will show the camera on. Yeah, any volunteer? Akhil, somebody? Same. Is there any other method? Everybody did this? You assume that separately theta 1, theta 2, 1. Vishwajit? Okay. So, you believe now my earlier statement that theta is conserved. So, theta is very important. Something like your wet bulb temperature and all that, no? In psychometric, you calculate the, I won't say it is like wet bulb temperature, some quantity, okay? So, this potential temperature is a useful quantity. Now, we will solve a simple problem involving numerical values and then stop for the day. So, tomorrow we will see how to put this theta into a chart involving pressure and temperature. That is called the pseudo adiabatic chart. Then you have a skewed temperature and lawn of pressure. That is a very important chart in atmospheric thermodynamics. So that will be do or die for you, because second quiz the problems will be based on that chart. So we will hang around with that chart for many classes. I am trying to I will explain most of the atmospheric thermodynamic concepts, like lifting condensation level, how much heat an air parcel will raise before it condenses and this thing, and after that if it raises and it falls off as precipitation, and very interesting problems involving moist air thermodynamics. We'll use, instead of using equations, we will try to solve it using charts. So I will switch to this, hopefully they will fix it tomorrow. I will sit whenever we discuss a problem. So I will take some, it is possible to change the color also there. So I will practice also. So we will, there will be lot of fun with this tablet. Problem number 20. Let us do problem number 22. A parcel of air has a temperature of minus 50 degrees Celsius, 50. A parcel of air has a temperature of minus 50 degrees Celsius at the 250 HPa level. A parcel of air has a temperature of minus 50 degrees centigrade at the 250 HPa level, full stop. What is its potential temperature? That is part A. You missed it? Wait. A parcel of air has a temperature of minus 50 degrees Celsius at the 250 HPa level. What is this minus 50 and 250 HPa level? That is the level at which commercial airliners fly. 250 HPa will be about 12 kilometers. Minus 50 degrees will be the temperature outside. You just open the window, people are gone. Not only because of the temperature, oxygen is not enough. Few seconds, oh, close. So this is the condition corresponding to outside. We will, so the first part is, what is the potential temperature? Second part, what temperature will the parcel have? What temperature will the parcel have if it is brought? What temperature will the parcel have if it is brought into the cabin of a passenger jet? What temperature will the parcel have if it is brought into the cabin of a passenger jet and compressed adiabatically? To a cabin pressure of 850 HPa. Okay, I come again. Problem number 22. Problem number 22. A parcel of air has a temperature of minus 50 degrees Celsius. The pressure is 250 hPa. First question, what is theta, potential temperature? Second question, what temperature will the parcel have if it is brought into the cabin of a passenger jet and is compressed adiabatically to the cabin pressure of 850 hPa, and it is compressed adiabatically to a cabin pressure of 850 hPa. Okay. Done. Very good. So you are considering the condition as P1 and T1, right? Okay. So P1 T1 is part A, theta equal to T into so please put in the values 3. Okay. What is this value? Yeah, this value. Just for the sake of it's being recorded. So, for the sake of clarity, 1.486. Okay. Point. We will try to solve it using the chart also. I will try to bring the chart tomorrow. Part B. Compress adiabatically to which one? This fellow. Okay. Gamma minus 1 by gamma. Yeah, please put in the values. Please tell me that value right side and then we will simplify. 1.41. problem is solved. Problem is not solved. The mathematical problem is solved, but the actual problem is not solved. Do you understand my question? I come again. The mathematical part of the problem is solved, but the actual problem is not solved. What do you mean? If you bring it to the cabin and you all the people are sitting, and what will be the temperature? 43.5. Okay, people used to Vijayawada, it's all right. But you cannot have a long distance flight with 43.5 continuously maintained. What is the funda? It has to be, after compression it has to be cool. So you require an air conditioner in the aircraft. Not only can you not use the outside air straight away, first you have to compress it to 850, because 850 the oxygen level is sufficient for the people. So the air conditioning system has to work properly. Okay. So from 250 HPA at this minus 50, so pilot will always announce temperature outside is minus 50, minus, it has significance. It is minus 50 and 250 HPA, that air cannot be let inside, it has to be compressed. So that power will come from the engine power. Okay. So after compression it is 43.5. So when the outside air at minus 50 is compressed adiabatically and brought into the cabin, it would have had a temperature of 43.5. Therefore, a further cooling by 20 degree centigrade is required. You can write down, a further cooling by approximately 20 degree centigrade is required to maintain the cabin at 24 or 25 degree centigrade, which is comfortable for most people. Of course, humidity is also there, that's another. Okay. So this adiabatically compressed air has to be cooled by about 20 degree centigrade. That is the inference you get from this. Okay. So he maintains it at, okay. Sir, why are you asking, why did you ask for the potential temperature initially? When we are walking now, when you go out of the classroom, when you are walking in IIT, what is the pressure? Atmospheric pressure. So if the 250 HPA is adiabatically compressed to the atmospheric pressure, what will be the temperature? 61. How much will the pilot have to cool? That is why the pressure is not 1000 HPA. Plane travel for long journey is uncomfortable. Not only is the pressure 1000 HPA, temperature may be comfortable, humidity is also a problem. They will keep it very low, because otherwise it will condense in the wrong places and will have give trouble cleaning and this thing and electric. The humidity is maintained at 5 to 10%. It will be extremely dry. Some people get nosebleed on long haul flights, transatlantic flights and transpolar flights. So this aircraft air conditioning is very much related to atmospheric thermodynamics. Shall we stop here? So tomorrow's class we will discuss how to do this using a chart, then we will get on with the charts. Thank you very much.